Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this channel, I'll be giving you practical information about heat and electricity and my applicable projects. Today, I'll tell you about thermoelectric modules or Peltier modules as they are also known. Maybe you have seen this material before and are familiar with it. These modules pump heat from one surface to another with the DC voltage applied to them. That is, they work as a heat pump. Thanks to the device we call heat pumps, we provide heat transfer from low temperature to high temperature by providing electrical energy. Sometimes kinetic energy or other types of energy can be used instead of electricity. You can find a lot of information about heat pumps on the internet. It's an incredibly detailed subject. But one of the most key details of heat pumps is the coefficient of performance, which we call COP. This coefficient can be expressed as a ratio of heat obtained from heat pump and the amount of external energy provided. In modern heat pumps, this coefficient is usually between 3 and 5. In other words, you can provide 3 to 5 times the heat transfer of the given energy. The key factor that determines this coefficient is the temperature difference between the outside air and the indoor environment. Modern heat pumps often use the vapor compression cycle. Now let us come back to the Peltier modules. Peltier modules are solid-state heat pumps. They pump heat thanks to semiconductor technology. However, the COP value in Peltier modules can only reach 0.5 or 1. This tells us why we do not prefer to use Peltier modules for cooling or heating in our homes and workplaces. No one wants to pay 5 to 10 times more for the same heating or cooling needs. However, Peltier modules still have some advantages. What are these? There are no moving parts, long-lasting, very little maintenance. Their small and light structures provide an advantage, especially at low power cooling needs. For these reasons, Peltier modules can be applied in places where there is a small cooling needs. I want to show you what Peltier modules are like. These are different types of Peltier modules you see in my hand. The Peltier modules is structurally composed of positive and negative pellets of semiconductor material placed between two electrically insulated but thermally conductive ceramic plates. Semiconductors are generally composed of bismuth tellurite alloy and some doped elements. Peltier modules can operate one surface as the heat absorbing site and the other surface as the heat dissipation site. We can change hot and cold sites by changing the polarization of the DC voltage we apply. In fact, this is another advantage of Peltier modules. However, Peltier modules should be used with heat sinks for absorbing the heat and dissipation the heat from the other side. Peltier modules have capacities from 1 watt to hundreds of watts. But if you look at the catalog values and expect cooling at the specified capacity, you will be wrong. This value only when there is a 0 degree Celsius difference between its hot and cold surfaces. When you look at the performance graphs of the Peltier module, you will see that as the temperature difference increases, the cooling capacity decreases dramatically. In practice, you can consider half of the catalog value for the cooling applications for 30 degrees Celsius temperature difference. Now, I want to show you some examples of heat sinks. All these heat sinks modules also used as a CPU cooler. The first type heat sink, which consists only aluminium body and fins and small one. These modules have generally the lowest performance. And this is second type heat sink. This heat sink is supported by a heat pipe and has better performance. Also, this is supported with heat pipe. Another option is water-cooled modules. We can say that water-cooled heat sinks have the best performance. However, this is a controversial issue. Sometimes modules with heat pipes may have better performance. Now, How do we get the best cooling performance? Here, I'll give you some information to get the best performance from Peltier modules. You should use heat sinks with the best possible performance for both and hot and cold sides. The hot side heat sink should have a higher cooling capacity because all heat absorbed and generated from the electricity is dissipated from the hot side. The best performance is achieved when the supply voltage is between 50 to 75 of the maximum DC voltage of the Peltier module. Increasing the DC voltage up to the maximum value reduces the COP value and may sometimes cause worse results. Thermal paste must be applied to the Peltier module and heatsink junction surfaces. It would be better to choose a type of thermal paste that has high thermal conductivity, long-lasting, and does not leak over time. If you want to make a cold box, you can achieve a maximum temperature difference of 20 to 30 degrees Celsius between the internal temperature of the box and the outside air temperature. Is it possible to get more temperature difference? Yes, but the cost will be high. At first, the energy cost will be much higher than the gas cooling cycle. Now, I want to mention about another feature of thermoelectric modules. The DC voltage applied to the thermoelectric modules creates a temperature difference between both sides and pumps heat. So, is the opposite possible? In other words, is it possible to generate electricity with heat? Yes, it is possible. But the conversion rate of thermoelectric modules from heat energy to electrical energy is quite low, around 3 to 5%. Of course, researchers achieve much higher efficiency in some special alloy modules produced for some special purposes. Heat to electricity conversion efficiency increases directly with the temperature difference between both surfaces. The efficiency value is approximately 2% for a temperature difference of 100 Celsius degree, and it can only reach 4 to 5% value for 250 Celsius degree. Since these values are a lot lower than traditional cycle power plants, they are not used directly in electricity generation systems. However, still there are opportunities for recovery purposes in facilities with waste heat. Of course, the feasibility between the recovery amount and the investment amount must be evaluated correctly. As a result, thermoelectric modules are not a miracle unit in cooling technology. However, due to their small structure, they can be suitable for small cooling or heating needs, or can be applied for recovery purposes from waste heat. I believe with the development of semiconductor technology, it is possible to achieve better efficiency rates in the future. In my future videos, I'll continue to present you applied projects on both heating, cooling, and thermoelectricity. Please do not forget to subscribe and follow my channel. Thanks, everyone.